Hello everyone, myself Professor Nayan from Department of Information Technology, Parvati Bai Ganba Mozi College of Engineering, Wagholi. So in the last session, we have seen about the different techniques of object-oriented methodologies that are your RAMBAC, then your CUDA-Jordan, then object-oriented software engineering by Ivar Jacobson. In this session, we are going to see the unified approach. So the unified approach is methodology for the software development that is proposed by the author Ali, and it is based on the methodology by the Booch, RAMBAC, Jacobson. They combine the best practices, process and the guidelines along with the object management group called as a UML. So UML is a set of notations and the convergence used to describe the model as an application. Then, however, the UML does not supply a methodology or what the steps to follow to develop the application. That is the task of the use case diagram. UA typically, that is a UA means unified approach, that is typically represent the interaction between a user and a computer system to compare the user's goal and the needs. The UA establish a unifying and unitary framework around the work by utilizing the UML to describe the model and the document of the software development process. The main motivation is to combine the best practices, best processes, methodologies and the guidelines along with the UML notation and the diagram for better understanding of the object-oriented concepts and the system development. So the unified approach is divided into the number of components. Here I have a list of the component. The first is the object-oriented analysis, then object-oriented design. Third is iterative development. Fourth is continuous testing. Fifth is modeling based on UML. Sixth is layered approach. So we are going to see one by one these components. So let us see first the object-oriented analysis. So the object-oriented analysis is the process to extracting the need of system and what analysis must do to satisfy the user requirement. The goal of the object-oriented analysis is to understand the domain problem and the system responsibilities by understanding how the user will use or how the user will use the system. It describes what system does rather than how it does. So OOA, that is object-oriented analysis, consists of the different steps. So the first step is to identify the actor. Second is to develop a simple business process modeling using the UML activity diagram. Third is to develop a use case for the same. Fourth is to develop the interaction diagram. And fifth is identify the classes. Then the next one is object-oriented design. The Booch provides the most comprehensive object-oriented design methodology. So the unified approach combines this by utilizing the Jacobson analysis and interaction diagram with the Booch object-oriented diagram and RAMBAC's domain model. So the object-oriented design consists of different stages. The first is designing a class, their attributes, methods, association, structure, protocol, and apply the design toxins. Then the second is design the access layer. Third is design the prototype user interface. Fifth is design the or list down the user satisfaction and the usability test based upon the UJs or the test or the use cases. And the last one is iterate and redefine the design or refine the design. Now the next component is iterative development and the continuous testing. So you must iterate and reiterate until you are satisfied with the system. Testing often uncovers the design weaknesses and provides the additional information to you how to use that. So the repeat and the entire process, talking of what you have learned and reworking your design or moving the prototype and retesting, is the continuous until you reach to your success. So during this iterative process, your protocol will transform into the actual application. Unified approach encourages the interaction of the testing plan or the integration of the testing plan from day one of the project. So the usability testing is the process in which the functionality of the software is measured. So you have to iterate your development process until and unless you are getting a final product. Now, the next topic is using the UML for your object-oriented development. So, the UML is formally incorporate the use cases for a modeling technique for defining the functional requirement of the systems. So, the popularity of the UML has caused it to be promoted as the notation for the business modeling, and as well as its original purpose of the modeling of the object-oriented systems. So, the UML is in the current notation of most of the enterprise application development nowadays. So, it has defined the UML, the name itself defined, that is a unified modeling language, models up with the very special notations and the related grammatical rules for constructing the software models. So, there are different diagrams under the unified modeling languages. We are going to see one by one the diagrams. So, here is a list of the diagram. The first is a use case, second is a class diagram, state diagram, sequence diagram, collaboration diagram, activity diagram. Then we are having a component diagram, package diagram, and deployment diagram. So, let's see one by one. Use case diagram, it displays the relationship among the actor and use cases. So, the class diagram, it models the class structure and component using the design elements such as the classes, packages, objects. Now, the state diagram. The state diagram will display the entire sequence of state of an object which undergoes in the responses to receive the simulation together with the object's responses and the action. Means the state diagram will show the state of the object, the current state of object. The sequence diagram. Sequence diagram displays the time sequence of the object participating in the interaction. It will show sequentially how the object transforms from one state to another. The collaboration diagram. It displays an interaction organized around the object and their link to one another. Means it will just represent the linking of the object, from how the objects are linked and collaborate with each other. Activity diagram. It displays a special state diagram where most of the states are action states and most of the transitions are triggered by completion of the actions in the source state. The activity diagram will just show the transition or the actions defined by the actor. The next is component diagram. So, it displays the high-level package structure of the code itself. Then there is a package diagram. It shows how the classes are divided into the modules and how the module one package can access the class of the another package. Now, then there is a last one, deployment diagram. It displays the configuration of the runtime processing elements and the software components, processes and objects which resides inside it. So these are the number of diagrams which are under the UML. We will go through each and every diagram with the example, and the question is always asked for define or write or draw the use case diagram, class diagram or state diagram, sequence diagram or activity diagram or component package deployment diagram. So you have to, the question is always asked on drawing the diagram for the particular system. If the library system is given there, if the college system is given there, medical system might be given there. So you have to draw the each and every diagram. We will see one by one every diagram which is listed here in further part. So the last point of the theoretical unit, theoretical section, is the layered approach of the software development. So we have developed the software development into the three layers. The first one is the view or the user interface layer. It is also called as a view layer. The second is the business layer and third is the access layer. Sorry, the T is here. It should be here. I'm really sorry about that. So the user interface layer consists of the object with which the user interacts. The business layer takes care of the business logic. It doesn't know where to move the object or from where they are accessing the data. They just know the processing. The access layer will always contain the object that know how to communicate with the places where the data is actually reside and whether it is in the relation database, the mainframe, the internet or the file. The access layer must be able to translate any data request from the business layer to the data access to the particular data set with the proper data access protocol, and also vice versa, means retrieving the response from the data set to the business layer. And view layer will just show the data, whatever the access layer have brought from the database, the view layer will just show onto the screen. So the responsibility of the view or the user interface layer is to show the data. It doesn't know from where it had been come, for what business logic it has been applied. So the interface layer will always deal with the displaying part. Business layer will always calculate the business logic. It doesn't know where the data is stored, but it will just contain the request and the response. And the access layer, it will communicate between the places that where actually the data is reside, whether it is a database, mainframe, internet, or file. It will just take the data from the database and again transfer to the business layer. So the business layer can give the data to the user interface layer, and user interface layer will display the data onto the screen. So that's it. This session will be completed with the theoretical session. From the next session, we will start the different diagrams. I will show the different diagrams which are listed under the UML, that is Unified Modeling Language. So we have seen the list. The question is always on the drawing the diagram. So I have also shared one link with this session. So please go through it. You will have a brief idea about the diagrams. So in the next session, we'll go one by one with the diagrams. Hope you have understood this session. If you have any queries, you can comment in a comment box. Thank you.